Welcome to Genius Connect. Please subscribe and share.
Good morning to all. Hello friends, I am Bhumi Trivedi, the Physics Faculty of Vijay International School. Today we will learn about electricity. Electricity is what? Which is the most versatile form of energy which is already needed in this modern life. So when we will consider electricity is having exactly two types we can consider. One is a static electricity and second one is a current electricity. Today we will discuss exactly about both, what is the meaning of a static electricity and second what is the meaning of a current electricity. So when we will consider the electricity word, it strikes in our mind that the things which are our surrounding, the comfort which we will get, that is due to the energy which is electrical energy. And any of the energy form when we will consider, that is a simple conversion from one form to another. So when we will consider the potential energy or a kinetic energy, the potential energy means what? The stored energy in a particular substance, and kinetic energy means what? When the substance will move, at that time energy goes by it. Now these two terms we will relate with the electricity in terms of a static electrical energy and current electricity. So when we will consider the static electricity, static means what? When the charge is not moving, when charge is at a one place, at that time the electricity which is generated, that is known as a static electricity. When we will understand that term in a different way, that when any two surfaces will come in contact with each other and both the surface as a having a certain friction between each other, at that time the electricity which gets generated, that is known as a static electricity. So how that static electricity work? If charge is not moving, then how that static electricity work? So first we have to understand about the charge. What is the meaning of a charge? As we are knowing that when any of the atom, when we will consider, it consists of a three major thing, which is an electron, proton and neutron. So when we will consider that when there is a transfer of a charges, when there is a flow of a charges, normally we can say at that time electricity is present over there. But in a static electricity, there is a no flow of a charge. Then how that electricity generates? As we have understand, that is simply the collection of a charge, or we can consider that charge is a static at a one point. Due to that, the electricity which is there, that is known as a static electricity. So due to when we will consider that when two surfaces will rub with each other, at that time there is a transfer of a charge from one surface to the another surface, or we can say that from the one object to the another object, at that time the electricity which get generated, that is a static electricity. When we will understand same phenomena in terms of a lightning, we can identify one major thing, that lightning is what? When the cloud will strikes with each other, over there also frictions generated. So that is a what? That is a static electricity. So this was the discussion in terms of a static electricity. Now next we have to understand in terms of a current electricity. So what is a current electricity? Definitely opposite of a static electricity. Over here in a static, the charge were in a static form, in a rest form. In a current electricity, that is the flow of a charge, flow of electrons. So that gives us the most important terminology, which is an electric current. So when we will consider electric current, what that indicates, the current is a what? Flow of a charge in a per unit time. That gives us the terminology of electric current. And the SI unit, which is a standardized unit for the same, that is amperes. By that, what we can understand, there is a flow of a charge, so charge needs certain energy. By which way they get the certain energy, that is known as an electromotive force, which get due to the battery or the way which is connected to the battery. That electromotive force is known as a potential difference or a voltage. If we will define that electromotive force or a particularly the voltage or a potential difference, when charge moves from one point to another point, the work done which is required to do by the charge, that is exactly what? That is exactly the potential difference which is required for the particular circuit. So when we will understand two major terminology, one is an electric current, another is a potential difference. Next thing which we have to understand, that is what are the particular components in a simplest electrical circuit. One is a switch, another is a battery would be required, wire would be required, ammeter required, voltmeter required. So what is the meaning of an ammeter? Ammeter is the particular component which measures the current, and voltmeter means what? That is the particular component which measures the potential difference. So potential difference, as we have understand, that is a what? That is a work done by the particular charge. So work done unit is a joule and charge for the coulomb. So another unit, it's a given by the scientist, volt. So based on that, that is unit is a volt for the potential difference. So when we will understand how we can relate the current and potential difference, that gives us one of the greatest scientists, which is a Ohm. So when the potential difference is directly proportional to the current, what we will get, that is the Ohm's law. But there is a certain conditions which is there, that temperature must be the constant. So when we will understand for the same temperature conditions, potential difference in the circuit is directly proportional to the current. So if we will remove this proportionality, we will get one constant, which is a resistance. So when we will understand that conductors, metals normally will allow current to pass from it, it's allow flow of an electron, means its resistance is the lowest. When we will understand insulators which will not allow current to pass from it, its resistance is the highest. So two ways, the current electricity, there is a two types we can consider, AC current and DC current, direct current and alternative current. So when we will consider the direct current means what? The flow of a current or a flow of electron is a unidirectional, means one directional. And when we will understand exactly in terms of alternate current or AC current, what that indicates, the flow of electron is not in a unidirectional. So normally in our daily life, we use the AC current and the equipment which are working, that is on an AC current. Now when we will understand, in India we are using it as a 230 volt, means our potential difference which we are getting is a between 220 to 230 volt, and the frequency of it which is a 50 hertz. So this was the discussion in terms of a current electricity. Now when we will understand it exactly in terms of a current electricity, we have to understand in terms of a heating effect. So the electricity bill which we can have every 3 months day in our life, that is a what? That we can measure due to identifying that is a 1 kilowatt hour. What is the unit for the power? Power means what? That how much amount of a voltage there, that is known as a power, which is a I square R, or we can understand it, which is a kilowatt hour, which is a units. So that when we will understand it, we can understand that how the calculation of the electricity bill would be there. So heating effect is a good for the certain instruments, and it's not a good for the particular equipments. So heating effect, which is Joule's law of heating, H is equals to I square RT. So it's a good exactly for the particular instrument in terms of a toaster when we will consider, and it's not good for the particular mobile chargers when we will consider. So this was the discussion in terms of a static electricity and current electricity. Thank you.
I hope you all would have enjoyed this video. Subscribe to Genius Connect and put on the notification to receive more such videos. Like and share this video too. Thanks for watching.